Hi everyone, this is Mrs. Montgomery, and I'm a mathematics professor at Southwest Tennessee Community College, and I'm making this video to show you how to put together a study guide or a notebook organizer in order to help learn mathematics. And what I have here is a three-ring binder. You can see that it is a 1.5-inch heavy-duty binder, and in this binder there should only be mathematics. So when you're putting together a mathematics organizer, make sure it just has your math notes. Now I'm going to open it up and show you how it's organized. Notice there are dividers, and they're clearly labeled and everything is neat. In the first divider, what I have is a place for the syllabus. So this is something you should keep with you in your math course, the syllabus that outlines the required materials and the grading policies. And then the second section is a section designated just for lecture notes. And it's very important when you take lecture notes that you write neatly and clearly so that you can go back and read your notes to prepare for exams and also to be able to study as you're learning the homework. So you can see here I've got things labeled that this was from lecture 1.1. I've got it listed as page 1. And you can see there are spaces in between the definitions. Now sometimes people like to go ahead and put highlighting for definitions, and that's fine, so you can always use highlighters and things that will help you to read what you've written. Now the next section is designated just for homework, and when you're working your homework in a math course, you should always write down the question and also how you solved it, and then you should be able to see your answer. So there's another section for self-checks, or this could be a section for quizzes. And again, you can see that everything is clearly labeled, what section it's from. The question is written out, and then all the steps on how it was solved is also written out. Now this is important that as you are writing out the process when you're solving a math problem, that you're writing it out in such a way that you can go back to it and review all the steps that you took to get your answer. And the reason for this is very often you can solve a math problem and understand what you're doing while you're doing it, but if you leave it for an hour or a day or a couple of days and come back to review it, for some reason, very often, it's easily forgotten. And so it's important to come back and be able to review the steps. Because mathematics takes practice. And in order to learn steps, you have to do those steps over and over again. So it's important to have everything written out clearly for yourself so that you can go back and look at how you did the problems. If you will follow these steps and organize your mathematics in this way, this will very much help you to be successful and to help you prepare for exams. Thank you.